From War Memorial Stadium in Little Rock, Arkansas, it's the midshipmen of Navy versus the Razorbacks of Arkansas. And welcome everyone to our ESPN live coverage of College Football Association action and an interesting intersectional battle here that promises to have plenty of thrills and surprises. Hello again, I'm Jim Thacker with Paul McGuire. First game for Navy, of course, without their great Heisman Trophy candidate, Napoleon McCallum. That means a difference getting ready.
Well, more often than not, when a team loses their star player, the guy that they use 95% of the time, it seems like a team will pick themselves up and play a little bit better. In the case of Navy, they are ready to play. They're not looking at the fact that they have lost Napoleon McCallum, but they've got Rich Klaus and some other people. And I think it puts a burden, a tremendous burden, on the defense of Arkansas, knowing that they cannot just key on one man like Napoleon. Now they have to look at everyone.
As a matter of fact, Arkansas is going to have to make a change of its own.
That's right. They're going to Danny Nutt for their quarterback. Now, Danny Nutt has a strong arm, a great release, no problem there. He's a little bit slower foot than Taylor is. But they're going to have to protect, I think, a little bit longer because they're going to also have to throw the football. And I think that when you have two teams like this, the atmosphere is that everybody wants to rise to the occasion and show exactly how good they really are.
And, of course, what you do have, Paul, two very fine teams. True, each has lost an outstanding player for this game, but there are good replacements coming on, and so it promises to be a hot evening of football here in Little Rock, Arkansas. Tonight's game is brought to you by Bud Light, the less filling light beer with the first name in taste. And on a perfect evening of football, it's Navy versus Arkansas with a packed house at War Memorial Stadium. Gary Tranquil of Navy and Ken Hatfield of Arkansas share a common trait. It is that each has just a little bit of a gambler's blood running in his veins. They might like to take a chance. For Navy, of course, it's the first start without McCallum. And how was that for the coach to get his team ready?
Well, certainly it's a big loss to us. Napoleon is not only a great football player, but a fine human being. And, you know, it can have two effects on you. Number one, the one that I wouldn't want to see happen is everybody to say, well, Napoleon's not here any longer. We can't win. We can't play as well as we could have before. Or it can be a rallying cause, and everybody can say, well, each individual has to play a little bit better, and maybe we can make up the difference that Napoleon's loss is going to leave us with.
Coach Tranquil knows one thing. Without Napoleon McCallum in the game, they're going to have to open the game up. And in order for them to beat Arkansas, the one thing I think he's going to do is throw the intermediate short pass routes, and they're going to throw the football.
All right, as for Ken Hatfield, he comes back here to his alma mater to put new life into the Razorbacks. The first game, tied Ole Miss, set the plays in. He turned his quarterback loose last week. What about this week with a new quarterback?
In the last two ball games, we've had a difference of our offense. We've been growing with our offense. In a triple option style offense where you're actually not blocking two people, you're reading the tackle and reading the men to decide who to hand the ball to or whether to pitch the ball. In the first game, because of the limited exposure against that speed of an Ole Miss team, we had a lot more predetermined plays where we told the quarterback, go on, hand the ball to the fullback, or go on, take it out and pitch it. In the second ball game against Tulsa, we called the same plays, but pretty much said, Brad, you read it. You totally decide what play to be in, number one, whether you want the fullback to have it, whether you want to keep it, and take what the defense gives you. So we actually read the triple option a lot more. And I think that's the key to success in option-style football, is learning to be able to read it on every down. And we're getting better at that each and every week. Tonight, we're going to read the ball a good bit.
And there you have some thoughts of these two head coaches who traveled different roads to get here. Gary Tranquil, who came out of Little Wittenberg in Ohio, little All-American quarterback. And Ken Hatfield, a hero here, an All-American defensive player, played for the national championship team in 1964, the Razorbacks of Arkansas. And they're set to match strategies tonight here in Little Rock. In Little Rock, because both teams come in, each without a star player. Certainly for Navy, they lose their Heisman Trophy candidate.
Yeah, they lose the Heisman Trophy candidate, but I'll tell you one thing right now. Talking to those players yesterday and seeing them, they are ready to play. They have forgotten Napoleon McCallum is out. They've got a job to do, and that's Arkansas. Forget Napoleon. He's gone.
Doesn't that usually fire up everybody else?
I think so. You're going to find where they kind of, what they say, they go down to the gut bag and find something. They'll find it.
Well, certainly they have that in store because each has a fine replacement. As for Navy, they got to fill some big shoes in Napoleon. They got a good guy to do it.
There's no question that Navy loses a lot with Napoleon McCallum out. But Rich Klaus, 5'9", 190-pound senior, shared duties a couple of years ago with Napoleon McCallum. Not only can he block, not only can he run, but he can also catch the ball very well. He is an excellent receiver.
Klaus was on the sidelines all of 83 with injury. He's an eager player to start. And how was preparation for this chance?
The preparation for the game hasn't been much different. I mean, I always had to be ready to play anyway. And with Knapp gone, as a matter of fact, I'm a little bit more sure of myself that I'm going to be in the game, whereas before, when he wasn't there, I never knew whether I might not play at all or I might play a great deal if he got hurt or something. And now, going in the game, I know that I'll be playing a lot. And I think it feels a little bit better knowing that I'm going to play.
Bill Byrne, sophomore quarterback, the first time in 13 years that Navy has used a sophomore quarterback or started one. But Bill Byrne is a very agile young man. You can see on this play right here, tucks the ball back away. This is the pass we saw earlier to Klaus. He's a heady football player, and he's got an awful lot of confidence.
And on the other side of the ball, Eric Wallace does for the defense what McCallum did for the offense. A great kick returner like this 95-yarder against Army. The defense getting better, and what's caused that improvement?
I think that goes all the way back to the spring. You know, we got together, we worked together, we lifted together, we were together off the field and on the field, and we've gotten very close as friends and as a unit on the field. And I think just from working hard and playing together, a little bit of experience from last year. A lot of guys got a chance to play last year. I think all that's helped us grow into a good unit. I think we communicate well out there, and I think that helps a lot. You know, we all know what each other is, what we're doing out there, and it helps us play together. I think that's what's made the difference.
Well, it all adds a little extra suspense when you have a key player out like that.
Yeah, there really does. I think for the defense especially, because one thing to have, the defense, they really don't know what the other team's going to do, because as we talked about this earlier, both teams have someone on the offense that's missing. So now it's kind of a wait and see in the first two series of downs for both teams.
All right, as for Arkansas, they of course have the new flexbone, the wishbone offense here. That's been something for the new quarterbacks to learn. And quarterback's gonna be a key position tonight for Ken Hatfield's Hawks. The change for Arkansas comes with the key quarterback. Brad Taylor on the left is out. He's their passing star, closing in on the records. Danny Nutt will be in. This will be his first start. Can he run the option? That's the big question. He certainly has a strong enough arm to do the passing.
Well, Marshall Foreman, that's right, folks. 5'9", 190-pound sophomore fullback. And Arkansas, if they're going to move the football on the ground, this man is the key. They love to get the ball to Marshall Foreman, not just on the ground, but also in the air.
No question he can run. They say he may not even be 5'9". At that height, is it a problem blocking those big defensive guys?
Well, at my size, it don't cause me really any problems because I'm already low to the ground, and I'm about as quick as any fullback's going to get. And from spring, I improved on my blocking a lot, so I think I'm ready to take on anybody right now.
Raven Caldwell, 6'3", 221, a great size for a linebacker, probably is one of the best freelancers in college football. He can do it all, and on defense, quarterbacks must worry.
Arkansas fans said to remind him of the great Smith. Well, how does Raven feel he compares to Billy Ray?
When Billy Ray played here, he was cut loose and had a lot of stunts and everything. And that's similar to my position. On certain plays, they got me doing stunts. They called me a wild man or whatever, but I think it's just as much freedom.
Well, the players are ready, the fans are ready, the teams are ready, the coaches are ready, and we're about set for football. The Billy Goat is ready. Billy the 22nd couldn't be here, but here's the Navy mascot. Billy Goat's representing the Navy team since back in the 1890s. And of course, the Razorbacks of Arkansas, represented by the wild boar from the Ozarks, a ferocious animal full of fight. And Big Red the 6th will be right here. You'll be hearing, woo, Big Sui! Decision giving Navy the option. Navy chose to receive. Arkansas will have the choice to start the second half. Ernie Villarreal from Carson, California, sophomore, will kick off for Arkansas. There in the red, the Cardinal. And the Navy, wearing the white and gold helmets, will receive. Back deep, Eric Wallace. Wallace is back waiting about 4 yards, 2 yards from the end zone. Here he comes. A wedge up the middle. Wallace up over the 25 to about the 26-yard line. And Navy on about a 28-yard return. Eric Wallace will have it first and 10. And here comes Bill Byrne, the first sophomore since 1971 to start in the backfield for Navy. He's from Pacifica, California. His tailback is Rich Klaus, replacing, of course, Napoleon McKellen, number 23. Number 28, John Berners, the fullback, a power runner. Wide receivers are Chris Weiler, 33, and Ken Hine, number 81. Here's the first play of the game. They're going to go straight to Klaus. Klaus in a slant to the right, fights through two tackles to the 30 and picks up about 3 yards. Defensively, it's a four-man front for Arkansas, a little bit unusual defense that Paul will talk about later. The tackles are Rodney Beecham and Frankie Lisco. The nose guard is Tony Cherico. Defensive end Raven Caldwell. Look out for him, number 84. Linebackers are David Basil and Nick Miller and Mark Lee, who plays like a defensive end. Deep backs, Wyatt Jones, Laskin Anderson. Second down pass. Over the middle of tight end Stevens. Short of a first down, about the 34-yard line. Big Mark Stevens, 6'2", senior from Hialeah, Florida.
All right, Mark Stevens is a big tight end, but watch, it's just a little under pattern. All they're trying to do is get Mark underneath the linebackers. You're going to see that is not a linebacker. Lasker, number 3, the safety, is probably one of the toughest men that they have in the secondary, makes the tackle.
Third down, 3 to go for the Navy. Possession play. Screen over the middle. He hits his man for first down. It's Hine. Stevens again, but tight end on a crossing pattern. Boy, they like to go to the big guy. He's a sure catch. That was Hine. Ken Hine, who came in from the flanker spot to put it in.
Nick Miller made the tackle.
That was Stevens.
Yeah, they're going to the tight end. What's happening? They're going to have to look at two. Rich Klaus, who's number 23 on that last play, came out of the backfield, and no one went with him.
First and 10, Navy at its own 39. Here's the fake, the play action. Going deep for the long one. Down there, and the man falls down. It was Chris Weiler trying to get on the long one downfield. It was covered by Kevin Anderson. They try the freshman cornerback. There he is. Arkansas thinks he's going to be a great one, but he's still a redshirt freshman. First year varsity ball for Morrilton, Arkansas.
Coach Hatfield was sorry. He knows Gary Tranquil so well. He said, once in a while, he'll throw that long bomb and try to keep you honest. But then, basically, they're gonna try to run outside with Klaus and hit you on the short pattern, and that's what we should be seeing.
Mike Ray is coming at flanker. Here he comes in motion. Second down and 10. He gets up the middle of Klaus. He breaks it. 50-yard line. Klaus still going into Arkansas territory from the 38-yard line. And there's Rich Klaus, the man replacing Napoleon McCallum, breaking his first big gainer over 20 yards on second and 10.
Remember what this young man said. He's been waiting a long time to play this position halfback with Napoleon McCallum out, but watch him explode. When he gets to the hole, the blocking is there. Now when he gets in the secondary, he knows what to do. Moves the ball away from the defender, picks up some blockers downfield. Number 33, Chris Weiler, is down there. Picks up a first down inside the 40.
And Bill Byrne has the midshipman rolling early in the game into Arkansas territory. First down play. The fullback Burner slams the right side for a short game. John Burner ran into all he could handle and more from David Basil and Nick Miller, the two active linebackers and the Arkansas defense. And in this defensive scheme, under Fred Goldsmith, the defensive coordinator, the linebackers certainly the key men.
They certainly are. They feel that the linebackers, Basil and Miller, of course, Caldwell plays the defensive end of the linebacker. They make the majority of the tackles.
Two wide receivers lob down the blower part of your screen. Ken Hine up at the top. Now they set men in a slot passing formation on second down and 9. Here's Byrne looking. Byrne fires downfield, and it is almost intercepted. Mark Stevens intended, but Kevin White almost had that one picked off from his cornerback post. He's probably the leader of the Arkansas defensive secondary. There he is. He may have had an injury. White coming off, look like he's holding his right arm.
He is holding his arm. Look at Wyatt. Wyatt's playing the corner. Number 3, Lasker, is the safety man. Stevens is there as the receiver. But what happened is Kevin Wyatt just left the wide receiver on the outside, moved in to help the safety, and now he's hurt.
Well, they've had to bring Charles Washington in, a sophomore who's been injured, hasn't played yet. So let's see what Byrne does going toward Washington. Here's Byrne right back to the air. Byrne's got room. Here's Byrne inside the 35 to the 31. short of a first down by about three. It'll be third down and three. Nick Miller and Mark Lee went back to make the stop for Arkansas. Another third down play facing the sophomore quarterback, Bill Byrne.
Isn't it amazing, my friend, when it looks like the quarterback has a lot of room to run, the linebackers are dropped off 8 to 10, but as soon as he crosses that yard marker, he cannot throw the football, and they converge on him, both Miller and Lee.
Why, they love the Hogs here in Ozark country. Arkansas, enthusiasm running high for Ken Hatfield. Fourth down and three, gonna go for it on fourth down pass. Now here, and be thrown for a loss. That was Raven Caldwell, number 84, making the big play again for Arkansas. Navy gamble down in Arkansas territory on fourth and three.
Raven Caldwell's gonna come out on the outside. John Berner, the fullback, was blocking on Caldwell, did not stay with his block. Once that happened, here comes Caldwell. Also number 50, Doug Rhodes, was out there on Caldwell, didn't stop him.
All right, that's a big play by Caldwell. Here's Arkansas now, out of the wishbone and a crossing action, Miller. Cara Miller up over the 40, explodes through about 9 yards on the play. Start by Mark Fearley, it's free safety for Navy. Arkansas backfield, Danny Nutt getting the call to quarterback, number 14. Carl Miller, 30. Terry, that's the left halfback. The right half is Terry Tatum. He's celebrating his birthday today. And the fullback, the dangerous man in the backfield, number 32, Marshall Foreman. Here's the wishbone formation. And they give it straight ahead to Tatum for the first down. About the 45-yard line, Eric Fudge, defensive end for Navy, hit him down, but he's got plenty enough for the first down at the 45. Navy defense needs some rest tonight. They'll not be able to stay on there and slug it out with Arkansas unless Navy can make some first downs. Well, the midshipmen came out with a pretty good drive, but Arkansas stopped them on the big play. And here are the Razorbacks now, who opened with a tie with Ole Miss, then came back to defeat Tulsa last week on four field goals by Greg Horn. This is true wishbone, one wide receiver. Full back, now here's the pitch out on the option play to Tatum, and he'll go nowhere. That time, Navy read the option play perfectly. Joe Papetti came up from strong safety.
Navy did play the option play perfectly, but Marshall Foreman, number 32, the fullback, at 190 pounds, they say 5'9", 5'7 and a half is actually what he is. When he went through the line of scrimmage, no one went after him. So don't be surprised to see him come back with Marshall Foreman going up the middle and that handoff to him.
James Shebist, probably the best receiver, is back in for Arkansas. They've stuck to the ground so far. And now here is Nutt looking to pass, looking for Shebist. Throws a little lob pass out in the cleft to Tatum, and it goes incomplete. He wanted Shebist, but he was covered nicely downfield. Rouser got in to put a little bit of pressure on Nutt, and he just lobbed it over the head of Tatum.
Marcus Elliott right there on right 56 in your screen. Did you see him blocking on Zaliski? Now, Marcus Elliott is probably the best offensive lineman that Arkansas has, and he is a good one. Great pass blocker and also a good run blocker.
Arkansas faces third and 11 at their own 44. Here's Nutt looking to throw, drills it. He's hit Shebist down here at about the 49. He'll be taken down, picks up about 6 yards on the play. Mark Fearley made the tackle, and it'll bring on fourth down for Arkansas. So Navy gave him the short one to bring up fourth down, and the Razorbacks will have to kick it away. There's Shebist, who's one of the leading receivers in the Southwest Conference here in the early going, 1984. And the punt is Greg Horn. Horn, who's had a punt of 72 yards, 56 yards this year. He's averaging 43.5.
Papetti
back deep, along with Eric Wallace for Navy. Oh, wow, booming kick. Nice one, inside the 10. Pulled down by Wallace. Here's Wallace, a dangerous runner, comes up to the 20-yard line. And so Navy will start from its own 20. First and 10, first period, no score. Navy, Arkansas.
Eric Wallace returns the punt.
Bronco 2 never made it. S10 Blazer 4x4 never made it. No four-wheeler made ever made it until the new Jeep Cherokee became the first to win all three 4x4 of the Year awards in 1984. And only Cherokee has an optional intercooled turbo diesel engine, a choice of two or four doors, and room for five. Get triple award-winning Cherokee performance or the luxury of the new Wagoneer, only in a Jeep.
What would you call a Zenith that's ready now for TV stereo sound?
Smart.
With a remote that lets you switch from VCR to computer to cable to games with one easy touch.
Smart.
Plus the new Zenith Chromacolor Contrast Picture Tube for superb color.
Smart.
The Smart Sets, Advanced System 3 from Zenith, designed with Zenith computer technology when you want everything.
Smart.
Navy versus Arkansas tonight from Little Rock, brought to you by Jeep Corporation. There's a feeling you can get only in a Jeep. Packed house, capacity crowd. This game's been sold out completely for weeks. Matter of fact, the Naval Academy returned some of the tickets they did not sell, and they were gobbled up in hours here by these hot Arkansas fans. Here comes Navy. Now Bill Byrne getting another look at the Arkansas defense. Kevin White is back in there, so he is not. Here comes Klaus. Gets a crease, and Klaus hits up over the 25-yard line. Well, Klaus is not McCallum, but he has shown some great running strength of his own.
You don't have to be McCallum the way the line is blocking Sears, Rose, and Coombs up in front, but watch Klaus. He does not hesitate. Straight ahead, east-west runner, north-south, whatever you want to call it, but when he explodes through the hole, that's confidence in your offensive line.
Well, when Klaus was in high school in Pennsylvania, he became the third leading rusher in Pennsylvania high school history, which says a lot for him. They give it to the fullback. Burner on a slant to the right for the first down. He's got it. Up over the 31-yard line goes John Burner, power-running sophomore from Avon Lake, Ohio. Probably the best running fullback Navy's had in a few years.
You know, this is a very good sign for Navy, because Navy said that they would come out and throw the ball. They must throw the football. But they are running the ball against Arkansas, which now makes Arkansas think run, forget about pass, and the short stuff will be open.
Here's Byrne on the play action. Byrne drills a crossing pattern incomplete, trying to hit Stevens. That's a favorite pattern there. They send two deep receivers, usually a wide out and a back, and then they bring Stevens across underneath the coverage. That was just thrown a little wide. There's Tranquil, and he sends the plays in with his alternating wide receivers, Chris Weiler and John Lobb. So Lobb brings the word in as Navy faces second and 10 here at their own 32. No score with 8.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Here's Klaus again, and he doesn't get much. Stacked up in the middle by Raven Caldwell, the brilliant junior end from Fort Smith, Arkansas. Another Bob, Billy Ray Smith, they say, and maybe not the same style, but he's certainly excited.
Raven Caldwell, when he comes down the line of scrimmage, you cannot delay at that line of scrimmage, because he just goes for the back with the ball. He has no concern about the quarterback option going down the line. He's looking for the back running into the hole off tackle.
Navy facing third and 9 from the 33. Draw play on the draw. And here comes Klaus, and he will not get it. Gets up over the 35, and then he is stacked up in the neighborhood of the 37-yard line. He's going to be a good 5 yards short on the first down. Nick Miller, David Basilos. Linebacking pair again.
It's a draw play to Klaus. Tony Chirico, number 64, is going to come in and make the play. He turned Klaus to the inside. He got help from his friends.
Bobby Joe Edmonds, D for Arkansas.
All right. They've got Edmonds in there. Edmonds takes it over the 30-yard line, down the 36. So Kevin Wyatt is not in the lineup for Arkansas. That was Bobby Joe Edmonds. No score, first period.
Tackle made by Robert Dill.
Navy now has come back again here in 1984 after losing its great Napoleon McCallum to take on the Razorbacks. Arkansas getting the ball for the second time tonight. Danny Nutt's back in it. Quarterback number 14. First and 10 from his own 36. Nutt takes the fullback, keeps back, pitches wide, and out comes Miller, cut down on the 40. That was the true triple option out of the wishbone, a fake to the fullback. Looked like he would keep. Then he pitched the last moment to Miller. Hit down by Vince McMahon.
Well, I didn't worry too much about Denny Nutt getting down the line of scrimmage with the ball that time. They say he's a little bit slower than Taylor. But on that play, he executed very well. They picked up almost 5 yards on the play.
Navy used a five-man front defensively with Fudge and Riles of the ends. Rutherford, a great one, and Zaleski, the tackles, and Pitbull, the middle guard. Here's a gift to Miller on a little bit of a counter-action play. Coming back to the right with Flo going left, and it picks up very little. Pimple, the middle guard, 242-pounder from Strongsville, Ohio, and that tells you a little bit about his strength, the way he plays. Watch it.
56 on 54. That's Elliott, 56 against Zaleski, 54, and look at the blocking in there. Now, Elliott wins that battle, but as long as he maintains, Zaleski maintains his man at the line of scrimmage, it gives his other people a chance to get in to make the tackle. That's good heads-up play.
Third and four for Arkansas at the 42. And they go to Miller. He's got the first down. Comes over the 45. Collared around the 48-yard line by Vince McBeth and Mark Fearley. And the secondary for Navy. So Arkansas, even though it's a smaller offensive line, opening some holes.
All right, Foreman 34. The man we say must touch the football. But just take a look at Foreman going in. He gets a block, not a major block inside, on Mike Taylor, number 62. Watch it right here. Enough to get him out of the way so Miller can pick up the first down. Good block.
They call this formation the flex bone, but what you're seeing right here pretty much is the wishbone, the full house backfield for Arkansas. Nutt gives his fullback, and Foreman looks like he ran into one of his own players and just stumbled forward to the 50 before the Zaleski to pull him to the turf. And so Arkansas reaches this midfield for the first time. 2 yard gain, second down eight upcoming for the Razorbacks. No score here with 5.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Well, it's been a perfect night for football. Weather's dipping down in the high 40s. No threat of rain, no wind. So it should be a great game, Paul, from that standpoint.
Yeah, you're up here under the hot lights. You're not down there where it's cool.
That's only the first quarter. Second and eight for Nutt. Gives again to his fullback on a slant. And Foreman trying to muscle his way through, and he can't get past Pimpo again.
Marshall,
Dave Pimpo, who shares the middle guard post with Dirk McFarland, makes two stops in a row, although that gave you an idea of some of the snap off the ball Arkansas is getting because Foreman picked up 3 yards.
Well, now Arkansas will go into a throwing situation. Andy Upchurch, 52 to center. The last two plays has not handled Dave Pimpo, number 61, and that's the reason why he's made the tackle.
Third down and five, and here's the play action face by Nutt. Nutt going down the left side of man wide open, and it is caught down there by Shebus, and he's out of bounds inside the 15. James Shebus, stopped by Eric Wallace of Navy. Perfect call by Arkansas, sending Shebus away from the flow, and for a flag pattern that almost spells six.
Yeah, but he just turns Eric Wallace around. Shebus, what he does is go down. The fake is in the line. The blocking is excellent. Look at the blocking at the line of scrimmage. No problem there. And when Shebus breaks to the post, you see where Wallace is, the left of your screen. He took him all the way into the middle of the field, broke back to the outside. Danny Nutt put the ball right on target to Shebus. They have a first down at the 12.
Opportunity for Arkansas. Here comes the ops again. Nutt pitches outside to Miller, and he's going to be thrown about the line of scrimmage. So Navy again reads the option, plays it well, does Eric Wallace, who was burned a little bit on the previous play, and Joe Papetti, the rover, or strong safety. Navy secondary getting a real workout here from this active Arkansas attack. This is not just the old 4 yards and a cloud of dust attack and the wishbone. They call it the flex bone, and they'll often set their halfbacks out in the gap as slot backs or wing backs. Right now they're full house, double tight end. Second and 10 from the 12. Miller to the right side inside the 10 and pounded back from about the 7 or 8. It's tough yards to make down here. Navy giving grudgingly, but Arkansas a little bit relentless now, pressing on after getting the big play on the pass from Nutt to Shebest. Rouser got help from Papetti on that stop up the middle. Gain is four, and it's third down and six for Arkansas. Ken Hatfield, who does his own offensive coordinating, sending the play on. Shebest is back in there. He's his big play receiver. Foreman is the guy they like to go up the middle. They send Shebest out to the left. Everybody else in tight. Air back is not going to Shebest over the corner, and it's incomplete. Shebest was there, this time covered by Wallace.
Chivas did that time. And he almost had to know they're going to throw the ball to him because Chivas lined up way inside on the hash mark, which gave him the room to the outside to run against Eric Wallace. And the ball is thrown. It's right on target. Chivas misses the ball. If he adjusts to the ball, he's got it. Hits him right in the hands.
Greg Horn now comes in to try for a field goal. Be about a 25-yard attempt. There's Horn, number 11. Tied the Arkansas record last week with four, and he missed twice. Either one of which could have given him a new Arkansas record, but he hit four that led the way to victory over Tulsa. This will be spotted on the 15, a 25-yard attempt. Not much of an angle, pretty much in front. Good snap, good kick. Arkansas looks like it's on the boards. It's good. Arkansas takes the lead with 3 minutes to go in the first quarter from Little Rock. The score, Arkansas 3, Navy nothing. Little Rock, Arkansas for the ninth CFA game between Arkansas and Navy. Arkansas has drawn first blood. Number 10, Ernie Villarreal, a sophomore from Carson, California. And for the kickoff, Eric Wallace and Rich Klaus are standing back at the goal line for Navy. Arkansas scores on its second possession, lead 3-0. Here's a little squib kick. Up man is taking it. It's a big, tall end. And coming up here is Chad Van Hulzen. With a little less than 3 minutes left in the first quarter, the score, Arkansas 3, Navy nothing. And we'll be right back at Little Rock.
At Markman.
And a stunning upset of number one ranked Nebraska, 17-9 at the Carrie Dome in Syracuse. Looks like Texas, it's a shoe-in to go number one. They routed Penn State, and Oklahoma rolled up a 24-6 win over Kansas State. We'll show you some more scores in a moment. Navy tried to get going here again with Bill Byrne, and now trail 3-0, Rome 34. They give it to Klaus. Klaus tries the corner on the right and gets about a yard. Not much more than that. David Basil, an active junior linebacker from Panama City, California, who was out last year, is very much in this year. He's the leading tackle.
Now they've got to go back. They threw some short passes. They were throwing them to the tight ends. Now with the, what they must do, and the man coming out of the backfield is Rich Klaus, number 23. He seems to be open when he comes out. Now they've got him on a wing. May throw.
Now they've got about four receivers out wide. Here comes Klaus in motion. Byrne on a straight drop, flips it out the fullback. Byrne gets a block on a little screen, and he's tripped up. Oh, what a big defensive play that was by Mark Lee. Or Burner would have picked up 5 or 10 more yards. Other scores, Auburn is coming back now. They beat Tennessee today, 29-10. They're in the SEC race now. Georgia Tech stunned Clemson. That's two losses in a row now for the Tigers after losing to Georgia last week. Michigan got by Indiana and a close one in the Big Ten. Notre Dame held off Missouri in the final minutes to win 16-14. Washington romped over Miami Redskins of Ohio 53-7. LSU stunned Southern California. Boy, the Tigers are roaring down in Baton Rouge. Here comes Byrne on a rollout. Flying, and he's got a man open here at the sidelines. It's Hine out of bounds at about the 49 of Arkansas. 81 Ken Hine ran a sideline pattern, and Byrne was able to stave off the Razorbacks until they got it to him.
Byrne might have been able to run with that ball too, Jim, but what happened was that they had Jones, number 15, on Hine. Jones never closed fast enough, and Hine just sat there on the sidelines patiently, not going out of bounds, making a reception, first down inside the 50.
First down for Navy, something Gary Tranquil says his offense must do. His defense has to have some rest to stay with Arkansas. Again, they got four quick wide receivers out. And they run up the middle with Burner, the fullback, trying to cross Arkansas up, and he gets a short gain, and that's all. Matter of fact, the ball was knocked loose there, it looked like, for a moment.
I watched Klaus, number 23, go in motion, and the play was on a long count. He just kept running and running and running, and by the time they got done, the play was handed off. He knew it was going to the fullback. He just ran out of bounds and went to the bench. Nobody was out there with him.
Here he comes back. He's a very intense young man, you know. He gets very nervous and uptight. And it has been easy for him sitting on the bench for a year watching McCallum play, although he was a big booster of his. Byrne fakes the draw. Here's Byrne. Going to the sideline to Hine. He's got it with open field with Hudden. 25-20. Hine down the 15-yard line as Arkansas gambled on an interception. And Ken Hine got some extra running room for another 15 yards farther downfield.
The defensive back made a tremendous mistake. And now watch at the end of this play. You're going to see the defensive back, number 7, Wyatt, I believe it is. He tries to go for the interception instead of taking the man. Watch this. He comes in front to knock the ball away. When you do that, you sacrifice this. And there goes Hine down the sideline. The tackle's made by Lasker, but they're inside the 15, Navy.
Great chance for Navy from the Arkansas 14. There go whistles. And whether we had too long getting that play underway or not, I think they had not moved the chain down. Officials had not moved the downs chains down, and so that's the holdup.
First down guy did. He was the only one.
Yeah, he was there.
He's heads down. Those other two, they're going to have to talk to him in a meeting to tell him you got to, when they get a first down, you have to move the chains.
Well, there's Billy and the Hall going at it.
33 seconds to go in the first quarter.
First and 10 Navy at the Arkansas 14. They trail 3-0. Both teams have used big plays getting the score. There goes Klaus hitting the middle, and then he's pounded back. Klaus about a yard. There was not much of a crease there. Nick Miller was standing right in the hallway with open arms. And so the gain is about a yard just inside the 13. Call it the 12. Give him a 2-yard gain. It'll be second and 8. That could be the last play of the first quarter. We're down to 3 seconds to go. 2-1. And before Navy can get back, the first quarter is over with a score. Arkansas 3, Navy nothing, but Navy on the move.